Welcome everyone to the first of many North American Rocket League Sideswipe tournaments. This is the Fated Rival Clash 1v1 for $1,000. I'm Vaudible, and joining me in the booth today is the one and only Hunted. How are you feeling today, man? First mobile gaming for Rocket League stream for North America. Pretty hype.
Dude, it's Pocket League. We're here for Pocket League. I mean, if I would have told you a year ago that you and me would be doing a broadcast together like old times, casting Pocket League, would you have believed me? I don't think so, dude.
I would not. No, I would say, awesome. Okay, maybe in like 10 years, once mobile technology advances enough for us to like have just not even a phone screen, it just appears in front of us as we like say commands.
Just,
but no, we're not that portion yet.
that's the future of gaming, right? VR. When are we getting VR Rocket League? You have to be the car though, so you have to do all the flips.
That's like that would not work out too well. But we had a few things we got to talk about first. Introduce people to the game itself, and then, you know, go into the tournament, how things have been going so far, and then the matchup itself. So if you don't know what Rocket League Sideswipe is, as you were saying, Hunted, it is kind of Pocket League. It is the mobile version of Rocket League. It's kind of more of a 2D space. You don't have the entire field to worry about, and usually it's either 1v1 or 2v2, or hoops for the game modes themselves. Really easy to get. You can get it on iOS or Android, and you can play it on your tablet. There's also emulators out there that some players are using too, so a lot of different ways to play. There's the touchscreen controls or controller, and there's a lot of debates a lot of people have with if you're only good with a controller, are you really good at Rocket League Sideswipe? We'll get into that a little bit later itself, but pretty great matches that'll be happening today and other weeks that we have as well, Hunted. Multiple weeks of play or matches that we're going to be having here as well. As you can see, weekly tournaments for 1v1s and 2v2s. 1v1s will be on Thursdays, 2v2s on Saturdays, and a final 16 team or player, depending on if it's 1v1 or 2v2, invitational happening on those dates, as you can see. So a lot of action to expect for this, and the players for those invitationals will be decided by winners of the weekly events and also top seeds. So gotta play in as many of these tournaments as you can. Have good performances and see how far you can make it, Hunted. A lot on the line today.
Bro, 13. Okay, imagine this. In less than 2 months from now, just over 2 months from now, we're going to be crowning a 2v2 champion in Pocket League who split $13,000 between the two of them for playing Rocket League Mobile. I mean,
that's only in North America.
And, I mean, right, yeah, Europe, this is
there's OCE, yeah. There's South America, different regions that you can compete in as well. There's other tournament organizations helping out with Psyonix running those events too. So pretty great stuff.
I mean, it's just, you got to give it up to Psyonix for not, I mean, of course, you know, sponsoring all the events and everything, but the game is like legitimately fun. Like that's what has drawn me to even wanting to do this, like cast this stuff. It's because the game is actually good. I mean, who would have thought that, like, Rocket League Mobile? We used to joke about it. I mean, legitimately. we used to joke about it years ago. Like, when is Rocket League Mobile, Pocket League is what we called it. When is that coming out? And it's finally here, and it's actually fun. I can't believe it. It's awesome.
I mean, you could kind of do something similar to it when it first came out on PlayStation, when there was kind of the screenplay mode using your Vita. That's what I did at one point, and it wasn't working too well. But now you can actually just play it on your phone casually whenever you want. But, you know, the ranks get pretty sweaty sometimes, so make sure you maybe add one of your friends on there. Use your Epic IDs for those specifically. And then it's pretty easy to get into those matchups. Just play for a couple of minutes and, you know, some great customization options in it, too. I'm going to ask you, what is your go-to car in Rocket League Sideswipe?
Go-to car? I mean, it was the Dominus until literally today. I unlocked... Oh, what is it? Which one is it? Oh, no. I knew you were going to ask me this question, too, and I forgot to look up what the car is called.
I mean, the good thing is you can just use your phone and do that pretty easily.
I mean, that is true. My tablet's over there, though. I have to. It's off screen. I'd have to get up, unfortunately. I'll look at it over the break. Let's come back. We'll call it a trivia question. We'll have whoever can guess in the chat wins.
Talk about the bracket before we get into these matchups. First, we had, I think, 256, give or take a few numbers here and there, players sign up for this tournament. The first one ever for North America, which is crazy to see. Down to 16 that we are having for this bracket. And I believe you can do exclamation point bracket in the chat if you want to follow along and see your favorite players. Over 15 grand champs that are participating in this, whittled down to a couple of them who didn't manage to qualify just based on the way things worked out in the bracket itself. But we have our first two matches in at the semifinals. We have Noah versus Alex. Noah, kind of a relative unknown as far as the leaderboards go. Alex is looking at his rank currently as the sixth place seed as far as MMR goes in one. So doing pretty well for himself. And then on the other side of things, King Granny, who you might know from 1v1s in Rocket League, content creator for Space Station Gaming, playing against Amir. And Amir himself is the fourth MMR player on the leaderboards for two. So doing pretty well himself there. King Granny, he's not even a champion yet, but he has all that experience from the main Rocket League game, trying to propel himself forward into these matches.
Look, if Randy wins the whole thing, like if he wins the entire event, you know there's going to be a video on it on his channel. And he, if we're not in it at least a little bit, I'm going to be upset. Just putting that out there for you, Randy. I'm sure he's watching. Or at least, I don't know, maybe he's sweating it out. Maybe he's tryharding right now. But
we'll have to see.
I'm just saying, dude. Come on. I mean, but for real, though, this is it's an awesome opportunity. Do we know which match we're watching first, Vod?
It looks like it's going to be Noah versus Alex that we'll be having up first. So Noah, don't really know much about this player. They took out Sierra, who was doing pretty well for themselves in the bracket up
like
to this point.
Set,
I mean,
though,
Sierra
right?
kind of took out players that people expected to make it into this bracket themselves. So Stone, really well-known streamer out there on Twitch, is one of those players who is pretty well seeded in pool number one and didn't manage to qualify based on how stacked that bracket was. Lost to Haru in the final lower round matchup. But Sierra took them out, took out YoPV and Haru as well. So they made themselves all the way into the top 16, and Noah still beat them. So look out for Noah when it comes to this matchup. They took out Fisky, depending on how you pronounce it, in that bracket too. That's another grand champ that is seventh in twos. And this is all from checking before the bracket started. Might have changed just based on them playing in between matchups, of course. So don't know exactly the current rankings for these players themselves. But this is going to be a good one because Sierra knocking out a lot of players. Noah also knocking out a lot of players, not even on those leaderboards yet, but looking to make a name for themselves.
Yeah, well, I mean, what better place to do it than the, you know, the first 1v1 tournament? You know, to be totally honest and to be totally transparent, I personally, and this is the same with Rocket League as well for me too, I've always been more of like the team kind of guy. You know, I've been grinding twos more than ones. I think I'm like silver in ones in this game to be fair. But I have watched a good amount of streams. I think Noxus, who is a player that also made the top 16, he's in the lower bracket. I've been watching a good amount of his streams. And there are some really like ones in this game. You know, obviously the game just came out, right? So we're just kind of starting to figure out how everything works. But I'm telling you, the way that you can control the ball in a 2D space is mind-blowing sometimes with how good some of these players are. And I have a feeling that ones, if you focus on it and really get good at it, it can lead to like some serious mechanical like craziness. There's so much you can do with the ball in such a small space. I'm super excited to watch some of these high-ranked games.
Well, especially the kickoff strategies too for ones are so crucial, especially in this game, just because of how close the goals are afterwards.
Right.
So like if you lose that kickoff, sometimes you can't recover well enough to stop that goal from going in. Happens all the time.
And
but in twos, like sometimes it still happens with your teammates just not paying attention as well as they can. So I feel like that kickoff meta is going to propel a lot of these players that are really good at once in those twos matchups once we get into those eventually. But it looks like
we are getting into
our first game, as we'll be seeing between these two players, Noah and Alex, on the board here, as they're going to be doing their best to see who makes it forward into that winner's final and top three in the money for that $1,000 that are on the line, Hunted.
Yeah, and so it's Alex in orange, Noah in blue, and I mean, already a pretty good start. The early kickoff kind of, you know, we talk about the kickoff meta didn't really go either way. Is that going to fall in? No. Enough boost from Noah. But yeah, that's the 50 you can't lose with all the boost and the merc to stuff it in, Vod. I mean, can't lose if you're Alex there.
Yeah, it looked pretty good when they were going for a lot of those challenges. Rocking the Merc. You know, we don't know exactly the hitbox styles in this game quite yet, because I don't think we've had anyone to break those down. But
that's
going to be an own goal for ANOAHH to tie things up there. So Alex quickly getting back into good favors.
And that's how I lose a majority of my games, right there. Oh, that's a great kickoff, though. ANOAHH had to hustle back. And now the mind games start. Full boost. And ANOAHH just hovering in front of the goal. I mean, it works out. You get, you know, boost control is so crucial in this game, and it really propels your car. It's like double or triple the amount than in Rocket League.
Well, it's so much easier to get it back, too, just because don't have to wait for those boost pads to respawn or go for, like, corner boost. You just have to touch one side of the wall, and you're able to get your boost back. Sometimes, if you're using a controller, it doesn't reset as properly as you would like. So that is one disadvantage for that. But as we were talking about disadvantages, well, when you give the ball to Alex in that capacity, well, it just puts you in a bad spot, and he quickly gets that goal, got the lead back, two unanswered goals, pretty spectacularly from what we've seen so far.
Well, Alex in blue here is just really, to me, trying to play this positionally well, you know what I mean? Just winning 50s and keeping boost. So this is going to be scary. That was close. ANOAHH almost able to reach that with the secondary flip. Great shot. That was pinpoint and beautiful from ANOAHH. Tie game, 25 left.
Nice to see from ANOAHH, and we have been informed by the chat, thank you, analysts that are out there, that all the hitboxes are the same, so it doesn't really matter what car you represent in Rocket League Sideswipe itself. Just going to look stylish regardless, but this looks like ANOAHH trying to be stylish on this play, delaying the shot, didn't go for the flip as quickly as he could have, so 8 seconds left before we get our first overtime of our Faded Rivals Clash 1v1 tournament. $1,000 on the line tonight. It looks like it is going to touch down overtime. Wow. Game number one.
I mean, I really thought that ANOAHH had that one. He had the flip coming down from the wall, and Alex was just in a tough spot. Now has to be careful out of the corner. Oh, has to be really careful here. Does keep the flip. Just going to be out of boost. That's a tough challenge, but he'll get back to it. Maybe Vaudable. Oh, no! Oh, what a save! Now can he transition?
Oh, man. Barely off the tip of their goal in a way. As he mentioned, trying to transition their best. Got that flip reset and waited to use it, but didn't really have an opportunity for it. Going to back off and go for a better angle instead. Have the extra power to try and flick it over top of ANOAHH. And off his side wall, but instead going to give complete control to his opponent. And that's first game going to ANOAHH. And this is a best of five, so plenty more to play.
And what a comeback, though. I mean, he was down, he was down a goal there with 25 seconds left, right? Was that it?
Yeah, 25 seconds.
I mean, that was exciting. I'm telling you, dude, with the way that ones works, and we're going to see it all night long. That was an awesome first game, by the way, to go to OT. But with the way that ones works, it's such a mind game, just like in Rocket League. But in this, it's like a mind game while you're in the air. A lot of it in Rocket League is on the ground, you know, big flicks and whatever. In Sideswipe, it's almost like flipped on its head, and obviously so far it's been awesome to watch.
Yeah, we'll have to see as things progress for the remainder of this matchup itself. I mean, Alex didn't really take him as much time to tie things up, only like 11 seconds or so. And after that, got a quick one, you know, a couple seconds after that. But really, it was ANOAHH just showing up, got that first goal, took him a little bit of time to figure out exactly his bearings. But once he slowed things down with the pace of play, it worked out pretty well for him. And that's typically been his strategy from what opponents have said before. But off the kickoff it goes. And Alex with the first strike, 1:55 on the clock.
That's awesome. Great play from Alex. And again, it's just the 50s, man. Do we even call them 50s in this game? I mean, are they truly even 50-50s? I feel like you get so much control over where you want to put your car. And, you know, we were talking about controller. I saw a couple of people in chat asking if the players are using controller. I'd imagine most of the top players are on controller. Beautiful delayed flick. Alex taking a 2-0 lead.
Great work from Alex there. Getting that lead strengthened even more. But two goals, I don't feel like that's going to be confident enough for him to get the victory so easily here, especially after ANOAHH delays their own kickoff and tried to see if they could trip out their opponent. Great shot, but in the net, plenty of ways to defend that one. It'll wait for it to pop up and just baited out the defender there. So 3-0. Alex confidently trying to take this game.
Yeah, and I mean, after the kind of the heartbreaking overtime loss, great way to start game two. But if Sideswipe has taught me anything, Vonable, a 3-goal lead with more than like 5 seconds left is never safe in this game.
Fair.
With how fast you can score. And we're going to see, try to go under. Oh, what a shot and a better save. Noah to me in this game has had the better placement on the shots, but Alex has been up to the task the entire game.
It's basically coming down to the speed from Alex and getting the reads and the reactions on what's happening from the advancements Noah's been making. And Noah's just been trying to figure, like, okay, where can I have just mind game this guy and think two moves ahead, but it didn't really work out that time. I mean, went for the shot, and that happens so many times in ones. If you get caught out and you're on the other side of the field itself, there's no way to get back if you run out of boost and you're just kind of hanging there. But 30 seconds remain, 4 goals. It's possible, but very unlikely at this level to come back.
It's like the fall of shame. You fall off the ceiling, no boost. Yep. You're just waiting to touch the ground so you can start playing again. Oh, man. Oh. Alex, what a great save from Noah, but Alex has been all over the orange side of the field. Is he going to give up a goal here? Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Can't get back. And hey, I mean, there's 10 seconds. Like I said, Vod, a 3-goal lead with at least 10 seconds left. We could see some craziness, but with the way that Alex has been playing.
Yeah.
I mean, hold on, though. Wait. Okay. Wait. Oh, he just missed it. Oh, so close. All right. So we got a tight series, right? Now it's 1-1. Yeah.
Yep. 1-1. I mean, that last goal didn't really matter too much. And honestly, with the 10 seconds left that he had, unless he somehow got like so many kickoff goals and Alex just kind of put down his phone, maybe would have seen a comeback there. But it's not going to happen that easily when you're down that much with that much time remaining. So going into game number 3, this is really where it's going to decide which of them is going to have the trajectory forward to try and propel themselves into that winner's final and be guaranteed, if I check my my math correctly,
he's got
at least $150 if they get third place. So pretty solid from there. If they make it into that winner's final, and then, you know, even if they fall into the lower final, it would still have a chance to get into that money and guarantee that much to go home with for their first 1v1 North American Sideswipe tournament here on the Rival Esports channel.
And I mean, this is the first best of five that both of these players are playing tonight so far, right? Everything else has been
they did play maybe one in the pool play and then one in the quarters final, so they've had a little bit of experience, but not too much, just because, you know, all the ranked matches are just a best of one that we've been seeing in the game itself. So definitely a different experience than they're used to.
Oh yeah, but here we go. Oh no, is that another own goal? Oh my god, that almost turned into an own goal and then an own save, but it does go in. That was close, Alex, making us sweat a little bit, but he takes the lead. And now I think if you're no, you got to get one back. Can't go down by 2-3 goals like you did last game.
Oh, there we go. Beauty. That was a great read from him. Saw that Alex was kind of free falling there for a moment, had a flip, but really didn't have much boost to work with just because he was delaying himself there for a second. So took advantage of that, went over top and into the net and off the kickoff.
Right.
That's happened to me so many times, Hunted. You go for it, it goes over top of you, they hit the side of the wall and then just quickly pinch it in. And that's a quick lead again for Noah there, but it might be short-lived.
And you saw Alex completely change his kickoff strategy. Doesn't want to see that happen again to him. And now ball control, he's going to actually lose it here. Did he come off too early? What a shot. Bar down, little tapper to play it through. Noah! What a big comeback. 3 in a row.
A big difference between Rocket League and this game, well, there's no goal replay, so you kind of just have to sit there, watch the celebrations, and just, like, think about what you have done for yourself in those moments there. But it is going to be a block from Noah. Might see something from Alex here as he's trying his best to preserve his boost and get it up and under, and there we go. Perfect read from him to try and bring himself back.
I love every time. It seems like every time Alex scores a goal, it's directly because of a beautiful 50. Just baiting Noah into playing the ball a little bit too far in front of him. And now we'll see both players generating flip resets on the ball.
Oh,
and it's
going
to be Noah to take it through. Back to the 2-goal lead. And we're just about at halftime. But I'm telling you, Vaughn, this is it seems like this game is broken wide open. The players getting used to playing against one another now.
Yeah, and you don't want to find yourself right in no man's zone under your net. And there we go. He's under his net yet again, trying to come back from the shot over top. And it's so difficult to come back from that scenario and get a save, especially when they have a flip and the power behind that to propel that ball forward.
This is an awesome match. I was kind of worried we were going to get 3-0s to start the night, Vaughn, but these players back and forth. It looks like it's going to be ANOAHH. If he can play some solid sideswipe for the next 35 seconds, should be in the lead. But Alex, want to put some pressure on. He's got an open net to shoot at Justin. Have the power.
Oh, no.
And is he going to concede? Oh. No, it's over the net. Back the other way. That. There we go. Two goals now.
Oh, man. Unfortunate there for ANOAHH. But you can't be too confident when those shots are coming through, especially if you have the time. You got to take it when you have that kind of a lead, but now it has diminished by a little margin. And we'll see if Alex can come back in the time remaining, but ANOAHH, smart for him to take it slow. Just try and wind down that clock as much as possible, less than 10 seconds now.
Oh, he needed the flip reset there. He didn't get it.
Ooh.
That's tough for Alex. He had an opening too. You saw ANOAHH coming down. No boost. Alex was able to get to it. He just couldn't get the flip back, and I think that's going to do it for game three here, Vaughn. Hold on a second. Yeah, no, doesn't have enough time. I'm telling you, this game is going to be one of, like, supercaster's curse. I'm telling you. Everything happens so fast. But I can confidently say that this time, ANOAHH is going to take the game. And now he's got one more game to win.
Yeah, we might see ANOAHH being the first player to move on into that winner's final and into the money as well, guaranteed at least 150, as top three are the ones taking home some portion of that $1,000 prize pool itself. And that's the most goals we have seen in one of these stream matches so far. This is our first one of the night, of course. So we'll see more from there. After this matchup, we do have King Ranny versus Amir waiting in the wing. And then some lower bracket matchups, depending on how things go with the winner's final. It's going to be a great night of some RL sideswipe, Rocket League sideswipe. And it's pretty good to be here, Hunted. I'm excited for some more.
Oh, yeah. I want this next matchup to start. I don't want to have to talk to you guys. I just want to talk about the game. It's game four. And we've already had an awesome series, ANOAHH and Alex doing battle and just trading games back and forth. It doesn't seem like either one of them, you know, tilting too hard, although I have no idea. I mean, at this level, I know if it was me, I'd lose one game and I'd have to, you know, might need to buy a new new tablet or something, new controller, I don't know. But, yeah, hopefully we'll be getting into the next game, maybe taking a quick timeout. Do we have those? What, tactical pauses in Sideswipe yet? Is that a rule?
We'll have to figure it out. You know, this is how things go with beginning esports that are out there, but it looks like we're getting into game number four. We'll see if Alex can come back and tie up the series, force our first game five of the broadcast and the tournament series itself. And no, he's not able to get the save. So unfortunate. The plank defense is not going to be enough to stop that from going in from ANOAHH.
And finally, the Dominus is not long enough for something. It's crazy. We need a Batmobile in this game to really really stretch the pace there. All right. Good 50 from Alex. Oh, ANOAHH will be able to get back to the ball. Great fake.
Oh
that
man.
Was sick.
ANOAHH.
I don't know if he meant to do that, but that was disgusting.
ANOAHH is popping off and not known on the leaderboards yet for being in Grand Champ in any of the playlist itself, so probably around the champ rank or getting close to it, but making a name for themselves nonetheless here. Two goals might be all they need just to have that advantage over Alex, who is starting to sweat a little bit for sure, using all their boosts, going for all the flip resets, and, you know, it's working out for him a little bit, but not getting those goals that he's vying for.
Yeah, he needs something. Although, I mean, there's still plenty of time. We haven't even hit halfway yet. He's going to challenge this one.
Oh, just too low.
But ANOAHH can't put it on me. Still does have to flip. Alex going to take it away. Now has to put this home, and he will. That's great from Alex. Good recovery. Gets one back, and we're halftime 2-1 now.
Yeah, I got a minute and some change remaining, really just a second of it. We'll see if he can have the patience to tie things up. I feel like that's been the biggest struggle for Alex so far. is that they have just been spending their boost as much as they can and putting themselves in bad positions, especially on the way back here. It does bounce in a perfect position for them to get back, so they might have a chance to break out of their half again.
How have I never used that recovery? I don't know if you saw it, Vod, but the recovery from Alex, no boost, a super smart play. I wish we had Telestrator.
Oh, no.
Oh, and a big save, too. He's got to keep this one out, though. This is for the game if he lets this up.
Oh,
Noah, that should be free. And it is. Okay.
Unfortunate. I mean, Alex knew that he had to spend it while he had it as far as the boost was concerned to try and get that save. But now, strategy of Noah is winning the day. So this bounce, I mean, waiting for it patiently. Noah just knows that he can bait out Alex and get these challenges and win the 50-50 so far, and only needs to have the clock tick down, and that might just be it for Noah to be our first winner finalist. As he's going to go in, but that's going to be a little bit too late. One goal differential is all it takes at the end.
G-G.
But Noah, our first winner finalist.
GG. GG all around. What a game. Congrats to Noah. No, that was awesome, dude. That was so much fun. So much fun. The fact that it's our first, like, full series 1v1 here on the channel, dude, that was dope. And I mean, gotta give credit to Noah for not tilting off the face of the earth after game two. He had a real rough game in that game, and then comes back and wins two back-to-back. That's awesome.
Yeah, pretty nice to see performance-wise from Noah. Alex, though, I mean, you were mentioning it, had a lot of the better placement and some of the mechanical skills that we expect to see from one of the top-ranked players in ones, especially as they are Grand Champ. I think they were ranked 6 as far as things go on the leaderboards itself leading into this event. It might have changed as they were playing in their downtime. But, you know, Noah coming out of nowhere, not even on the leaderboards itself, making a name for themselves, getting in that money, guaranteed at least third place. But hopefully they are going to be vying for more there. And we're going to be taking a little bit of a break as we get this next match set up. We have King Granny and Amir coming up next.